Go. Hi everybody, it's Miss Marie, and I'm going to kick off our fall story times today with stories about bicycling. The reason I picked bicycling is because bicycling is one of my new favorite hobbies, and I find that fall is a great time to do outdoor things when the weather is just getting a little bit cool and it's not too hot out. So I thought we would kick off fall story time with stories about bicycling. But first, I'm gonna go for a ride. Put on my helmet, strap it in. Fit tight. Yep. Check my brakes. Make sure everything is safe and works in order with the bike. All right. I will see you soon, and I'm going to go for my ride, and I'll come back and read you some great stories about bicycles. Okay? All right, everybody. I am back from my bike ride, and I'm feeling great. I hope you get a chance later to go out and go for a bike ride, too. But first, let's hear some great stories about bicycles and some bicycle safety pointers that we're going to go over. Before we do that though, let's learn a new song to start story time. Every time we have a new story time session, we do a song that kind of introduces everybody to story time, gets us ready to settle down. Usually I pick one that maybe is a little quiet, a little calm. This time I thought we would pick one that's a little exciting. It's called Shaken Like a Leafy Tree, and it kind of reminds me of all the trees right now that are just starting to drop their leaves. I know there's one in my yard that's really dropping their leaves early, and it's driving us a little crazy. We clean it up every day. So let's do Shaking Like a Leafy Tree by the Wiggles. Are you ready? Here it goes. Everybody shake high and low, shaking like a leafy tree. Everybody shake high and low, shaking like a leafy tree. Shake, 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 shake out your branches. Bend, 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 bend in the breeze. Shake, 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 shake all around you. Stretch, stretch, stretch. Ooh. Everybody shake high and low. Shaking like a leafy tree. Everybody shake high and low. Shaking like a leafy tree. Are you shaking like a leafy tree? Whew, good. I hope you shook out all of those sillies and you're ready to listen to some stories. Okay, our first story for today is called Everyone Can Learn to Ride a Bicycle. And this is written and illustrated by Chris Roschka, who is a 2-time Caldecott Medal winner. So he's a great writer and illustrator. And he says that everyone can learn to ride a bike. And this book is published by Schwartz Wade Books in New York. Want to learn to ride a bicycle? First, you need to choose. There's a lot of bicycles there to choose from, right? The perfect one for you. Let's go. Looks like her grown-up is maybe like, oh boy, that's a lot of boy bikes to choose from. But I think maybe she's going to pick this one. Watch everyone ride. They all learned how, so lots of people already know how. So if you watch them, maybe that can help you. Come on, let's give it a try. Training wheels are helpful. They keep you from tipping over. It's true. Everybody usually learns to ride either, well, first on a tricycle, and then they go to two wheels with the training wheels on the side. If we raise them up a smidge, you'll begin to feel your balance. It's true, training wheels are a little bit unbalanced, so you go back and forth a little bit so you can learn how to balance yourself without the training wheels, actually. Now we take them off. After you've been riding for a while with the training wheels, you can take them off. That's a bit scary, but try it. It's true, if you leave them on for too long, you get used to them, and then you're scared to take them off. But first you try it in the grass. It's a little too hard to pedal. Maybe down a small hill? I think her face looks a little scared though. I don't think she likes that. Oh dear. It just looks like she tumbled off her bicycle. All right, her grown-up says, I'll hold on. This is also very helpful. If somebody can hold on to it while you start. Pump your legs, and look, the grown-up is holding it for her and running along, holding it, trying to keep up. Finally, the grown-up has to let go. because she's going a little too fast now. Oops. You nearly had it. She fell down again. That's okay. She's okay. Oh, don't give up. You'll get it. She's getting sad when her grown-up is hugging her and saying, it's okay. It's okay. You'll get it. Find the courage to try again. And again. And again. And again and again and again and again until she keeps on falling. She keeps on trying. And then one day, by luck, grace, and determination, you are riding. And look at her hair blowing back. She's getting a good ride there on that bicycle. Oh, that's great. It did take some luck and some grace and determination. And she is riding a bicycle. All the other bicyclists out there. And that is the end of that story. Oh, except the one more thing. It says, and now you'll never forget how. And that is very true. Once you learn to ride a bicycle, you won't forget how. I can attest to that because I didn't ride a bicycle for many, many years. And then I got right back on and I was able to do it again. And now it's one of my favorite things to do. So the book is really true. All right, would you like to do, I'm going to do some pictures on the board. Sometimes we do stuff on a board. Sometimes we do something that is nonfiction, something that's informational. And our older kids especially love this at the library. And it's very good practice for learning to read for information. Because most children's books that are information books, which are called nonfiction, they have pictures to help you to go along with the words. So I'm going to put the pictures up here, and then I'm going to read you some words, and we are going to try to figure out which picture goes with those words. How's that look? Can everybody see those? All right, take a good look at all those pictures. And I am going to read you a fact, and we'll see which one goes with it. These are some bicycle safety tips. Riding a bike is a lot of fun, but you have to be safe and careful. So let's read one tip, and you tell me which picture it goes with. Never wear flip-flops, only closed shoes like sneakers. Do anybody see a picture that would go with that statement? Never wear flip-flops. Only closed shoes like sneakers, closed-toed shoes. I see, oh, do you see it? A pair of flip-flops. So that goes with those words. Okay, excellent. Let's do another one. The strap of your helmet should fit tightly enough that only one finger can fit between your chin and the strap. Do you see anybody testing out their helmet to make sure that it fits properly? Well, I see a couple pictures with helmets in it. Oh, I think I see one with somebody with their finger through the strap. I see it. All right, it's this one right here. He's got his finger through the strap to test to make sure that it's tight enough. So I'm going to put that with those words that we just read. There we go. Both hands should be on the handlebars at all times. Do you see any pictures with anybody with their hands? I see several with hands on the handlebar, but one has check marks. Oh, look at that. It has check marks next to where you should have your hands. I think that is the proper picture for this statement. So let's put that there. Both hands should be on the handlebars at all times. Very good. Never wear headphones. You need to be able to hear traffic. Does anybody see anything that could go with those words? Never wear headphones. You need to be able to hear traffic. I never wear headphones. I see some headphones. We also call them earbuds because they go right into your ears.
And while I love to listen to music, I do not listen to music while I'm riding my bicycle. I need to hear other bicyclists and I need to hear traffic. All right. Keep your bicycle in good repair. That means take care of it, make sure everything is working before you go on it. Do you see any kids taking care of their bicycles here? I do. I see this boy has his bicycle turned upside down and he's checking probably the brakes and the air pressure in his tires. So I think it's this one. He's keeping his bicycle in good repair, taking care of it. Very good safety tip. That's why I check my brakes before I go on my bike. Your helmet should be worn low on your head, about 2 finger widths above your eyes. Do you see anybody checking out a helmet? Making sure that it's 2 finger widths above the eyes. Oh, I see it. I see this boy right here. He's put his 2 fingers between his eyes and his helmet to make sure that the helmet is sitting in the right spot, not too far back. All right, so we'll put those words with that picture. And I have one more. Your bike should be the right size for you. And I do see a picture with lots of different size kids and lots of different size bikes. And that is very important because if your bike is too big or too small, it won't be safe for you to ride. It needs to be just the right size for you. And there are those kids, all different ages and sizes and all different size bikes. All right. Terrific, everybody. You did so great with that one. Are you ready to hear another fun story? This one is called Hello Bicycle. Hello Bicycle. And it's by Ella Boyd and illustrated by Daniel Griffo. And let's see, who is the publisher? It is published by Marshall Cavendish Children. And that is some bicycle she's got. Basket and streamers. Oh, mirrors, which is good. That's nice and safe. Does she have, I see, well, she's got a little seat for, well, her cat's in her seat right now, but let's see. She's got this bicycle. Hello, bicycle. And there she is, excited about her new bicycle. Bye-bye, blue. Hello, red. Shiny paint, smoking dread. So blue is her old bicycle, which is actually a tricycle because she was little. Now she's getting a bicycle, which is 2 wheels. And it's got smoke and tread, meaning brand new tires that are ready for the road. Climb the seat, twist the bars, helmets on, check for cars, always check for cars, right? And there she is in the road. Oh, and I see the leaves are coming down. It must be autumn in this book too. Just like it's going to turn out in here. Pedals up, dad's in view, ready, start, coming through. So dad is watching, and she takes her bicycle, her brand new bicycle, down the road. Down the hill, I bump, 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 feel it on my rump, rump, rump. That means her backside is getting a little bumped around. The cat is chasing her, and it looks like maybe mom and her little brother are watching over here. Miss the rock, skim the hole, squish the hose, dodge the pole. Oh my goodness, seems like there's a lot of things in her way, but she's doing a good job keeping control. Reach a fence, dog won't stay, hear a bark, speed away. Oh no, she's scared of the dog. But hopefully this person's dog is actually friendly, he's just barking. And hopefully he stays in his yard. Next house down, girls can't skate, steer around, doing great. So here are some girls learning to skate, and she's got to make sure she stays away from them too. She doesn't want to bump into anybody who's sharing the road with her. Up ahead, hill looks high. I'm not scared, gotta try. So actually it's hard to get up the hill. That will take her some time, but going down is going to be pretty fast. So she's got to be careful and be in control. My heart goes thump, thump, thump when I make the jump, bump, rump. So there was a little bit of a jump at the end. I don't know if she meant to take it, but she took it and she kept control. And she wasn't going too fast. Well done, Red. We made Dad grin. Her dad is very proud of her. but she's learning to ride her bicycle so well and so safely. Now, let's make him smile again. So she's gonna get back up on that bicycle and do it again, because remember what we learned in the other book? Once you learn, you won't forget. And there she is, gonna show Daddy she can do it again. Oh, let me put this fan over here. And now I'd like to teach you a song, an old, old song. It is called Bicycle Built for Two. I don't know if you have ever seen a bicycle built for two. This is a picture of one. It's a bicycle that has two seats on it, so two people can ride at the same time. And this song is a very old song, and it's called Daisy, Daisy, or Bicycle Built for Two. And it's a really fun, cute old song, and I thought you might enjoy learning this one. It goes like this. Daisy, Daisy, give me your answer, do. I'm half crazy, all for the love of you. It won't be a stylish marriage, I can't afford a carriage, but you'll look sweet upon the seat of a bicycle built for two. We can sing it one more time, ready? Daisy, Daisy, give me your answer, do. I'm half crazy, all for the love of you. It won't be a stylish marriage, I can't afford a carriage, but you'll look sweet upon the seat of a bicycle built for two. And that's a really fun old song. My Nana used to sing it to me. I used to sing it to my kids. It's an old one, but it seemed perfect for today. And we have one more fun book, Duck on a Bike. And this is by one of my favorites, David Shannon. He writes the No David books, and he illustrates them as well. He's the author and the illustrator of No David. This is called Duck on a Bike. And I see some streamers. A lot of bikes have streamers. And let's see, who is the publisher of this book? This book is published by Blue Sky Press. And there's the duck on a farm, and he sees a bike with streamers and a bell. A lot of people put a bell on their bike so they can bing, 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 let other bikers know or other people know that they're coming through. One day down on the farm, Duck got a wild idea. I bet I could ride a bike, he thought. He waddled over to where the boy parked his bike, climbed on, and began to ride. At first he rode very slowly, and he wobbled a lot, but it was fun. I think the bike might be a little bit big for him. He doesn't have great control over it, but let's see what happens. Duck rode past Cow, waved to her. Hello, Cow, said Duck. Moo, said Cow. But what she thought was, a duck on a bike? That's the silliest thing I've ever seen. It is pretty silly. Then Duck rode past Sheep. Hello, Sheep, said Duck. Bah, said Sheep. But what she thought was, he's going to hurt himself if he's not careful. And she is correct about that. He has to be careful. Duck was riding better now. He rode past Dog. Hello, Dog, said Duck. Woof, said Dog. But what he thought was, that's a mighty neat trick. Then Duck rode past Cat. Hello, Cat, said Duck. Meow, said Cat. But what she thought was, I wouldn't waste my time riding a bike. I don't know if it's a waste of time, but I guess Kitty Cat likes to lay there. Duck pedaled a little faster. He rode past Horse. Hello, Horse, said Duck. Nay, said Horse. But what he thought was, you're still not as fast as me, Duck. That could be true. It could be that Horse is faster than even a duck on a bike. Duck rang his bell as he rode towards Chicken. Hello, Chicken, said Duck. Cluck, cluck, said Chicken. But what she thought was, watch where you're going, Duck. Then Duck rode past Goat. "Hello, goat," said duck. "Meh," said goat. But what he thought was, "I'd like to eat that bike." And as you can see, goat is not a picky eater. He's eating right out of the trash can. Duck stood on the seat. Uh-oh, this is dangerous. And rode past pig and pig. And "Hello, pigs," said duck. "Oink," said pig and pig. But what they thought was, "Duck is such a show-off." Yeah, I don't think he's being very safe right now. Then duck rode no hands past mouse. Do you remember what our rule said? Both hands always on the handlebars. He's riding with no hands. "Hello, mouse," said duck. "Squeak," said mouse. But what he thought was, "I wish I could ride a bike just like duck." And there's little mouse. Duck being tricked. Dangerous. Uh-oh. Suddenly, a whole bunch of kids came down the road on bikes. They were in such a hurry, they didn't see duck. They parked their bikes by the house and went inside. I guess they're going into the farm. And now, look at the animals looking at all those bikes. And what are they thinking? They seem a little bit excited. Now, all of the animals had bikes. They rode around and around the barnyard. "This is fun," they all said. "Good idea, duck." Look at those animals on the farm riding around on bicycles. That is very silly. Then they put the bikes back by the house, and no one knew that on that afternoon there had been a cow, a sheep, a duck, a dog, a horse, a chicken, a goat, and two pigs, a mouse on a bike. Oh my goodness. He looks like he's like hiding. He is hiding something. The end. Uh-oh. What is the duck looking at? The tractor on the farm. I think it might be another story, actually. The duck on a tractor. Oh my goodness. Well, that was a lot of fun. So before we go, I would like to say that each week, if you'd like to participate at the end of our stories, after we've sung our goodbye song, I'm going to go over and make a craft. The craft materials, most of them are pretty easy. You might have a lot of the stuff at home, or you can email me and let me know that you'd like to pick up a bag of the crafts, and they'll be 4 weeks at a time. The crafts will be in a little bag that you can participate with, but we'll do that at the end. Right now, we're going to sing our goodbye song, all right? And I think I like the best one is "See You Later, Alligator." Right, here we go. "See you later, alligator, in a while, crocodile. Give a hug, ladybug, blow a kiss, jellyfish. See you soon, big baboon, out the door, dinosaur. Take care, polar bear, wave goodbye, butterfly." All right, goodbye. And you can stop now, or you can come and join me for the craft. Thanks. Okay, so if you picked up a craft bag, what you found in there was, for this week, is a little cutout of a bicycle. And it could be pink or red, whichever side you pick. A brass brad for holding things together. A strip of cardstock. And you'd have to bring your own paper plate, because I couldn't fit them in the bag. And what I did was I used a pen, and I poked a hole in the middle of the plate, and I poked a hole towards the end of this strip of paper, and I'm going to put the brad through the paper plate, just like this, and then I'm going to put it through on the back of this strip of paper, and then open it up. And so now what you have is a strip of paper going around a white paper plate. We're gonna fix that. We're gonna make it into a little bicycle scene. So I'm gonna take some glue. I'm gonna put that on my bicycle in a couple different spots. Or you could put it right on the strip of paper too. And I'm gonna glue that on there. And now, I need to add, this is just a boring paper plate, so I need to add some details to make it look like a nice little bike ride. So
think I'm gonna add some grass. We're gonna be going down a road that's grassy. Like that, grassy road. Maybe I'm gonna put some flowers too. First, I'm putting some stems. And I'm gonna add some flowers to those stems. Any color you like. I'm using markers. You could use crayons as well. Maybe I'll put some different colors. Let's try some orange over here too. I'm just gonna be pretty flowers. And you could even draw. I'm taking a black marker. I'm gonna draw a road. There's a road there. And we're just gonna follow around on that road. I'll take a bicycle ride. And that is our bicycle craft. And hopefully this wasn't too hard. I think we have all the materials mostly at home, or that I put in the bag for you. There's one more thing I put in the bag for you that you don't need for today. You can put this on your helmet. It's a reflecting sticker. And I'm going to add it right to the back of my helmet right here. All right. Or you can put it on your bicycle. All right, that's just a little extra thing I put in there for you today. And I hope you enjoy and go out and try and ride your bike or scooter, skate, whatever you've got. All right, have a great day, and I will see you next week. We're going to be visiting the farm, another fun fall activity.